Greetings, map heads, and welcome to another Geocast. I'm Travis McPhail, the engineering lead for the Maps team on the Google Maps platform. And today, I'm going to show you the new WebGL-powered features for the Maps JavaScript API. In case you missed Google I/O this year, we announced the beta release of two new features that let you control and render on the base map in ways that before would have been literally impossible. Tilt and rotation and WebGL overlay view. Let's take a look at what they can do. With tilt and rotation, you can manually and programmatically control the map in three dimensions for the first time. This creates a dramatically different and more immersive mapping experience for your users. This is particularly true for cities, where you can really see the visual impact of our oblique 3D building models being available in your web apps for the very first time. To enable tilt and rotation, all you need to do is create a map ID that uses the JavaScript vector map in the Maps Management page of the Google Cloud Console and check the tilt and rotation boxes. Once enabled, your users will be able to manually control the tilt and rotation of the map by holding the Shift key and either dragging the mouse or using the arrow keys. Programmatically, you can set the initial tilt and rotation of the map using the tilt and heading properties when you create a map instance, as well as at runtime by calling setTilt and setHeading on the map object. But we want to do more than just give you a better map experience. We also want to give you the ability to build amazing new experiences with the map. And this is where WebGL Overlay View comes in. The vector map is made possible by WebGL, which renders the map client-side using the device's GPU. WebGL Overlay View puts this rendering power directly in your hands by exposing lifecycle hooks in the same WebGL rendering context we use to render the base map. So what does that mean? It means for the very first time ever, you can render 2D and 3D objects directly on the base map with perspective, occlusion, and depth in 3D space. In this example, multiple objects and 3D models are rendered onto the map. Notice how here, when objects move closer or farther away, they scale relative to their individual distance from the camera. And how when the map is rotated, they are occluded by the building models. And lastly, we're also introducing a new Move Camera API that lets you simultaneously change the tilt, rotation, center, and zoom of the map. Call Move Camera in an animation loop, and you now have the ability to apply smooth camera animations to the map, which opens up even more possibilities for user experience. And frankly, it just makes things look pretty cool. You can try all of this right now in the beta channel of the Maps JavaScript API by setting the V parameter to beta. To learn more, check out our docs and help us improve these new WebGL powered features by reporting any issues, bugs, or feature requests in our public issue tracker. You can also watch my talk from Google I/O for a more detailed explanation of all of these features. Give them a try. Let us know what you think. And as always, happy mapping.
Got it, you can cut.
Okay.